现在开始中英文读书啊。第一篇我们学习一下，拥有这九种特质让你更具魅力。你有没有想过是什么让一个人有吸引力？ Have you ever wondered what makes a person attractive? 可是因为他们富有魅力的个性， It might just be their magnetic personality.这意味着他们拥有某些特质，能立即让周围的人感到被认可、被尊重和欢迎。This means that they hold certain qualities that instantly make the people around them feel acknowledged, respected, and welcomed. 想知道他们是怎么做到的吗？Curious to know how they do it. 以下是让你具有吸引力的九个性格特征。Here are 9 personality traits that make you magnetic. 第一，活在当下。Number 1, they are present. 有魅力的人有一个明显的特点，总是活在当下。活在此刻 ,magnetic people have the distinct trait of always being present and living in the moment. 正因如此，他们会让你觉得自己被看见、被倾听、被重视、被欣赏。Because of these, they can make you feel seen, heard, important, and appreciated.根据简易事物上的一篇文章，一个人活在当下，更有可能拥有高水平的生产力、创造力和更好的决策能力。According to an article on Facial Things, a person who is present is more likely to have higher levels of productivity, creativity, and a better ability.To make decisions. 这篇文章还说，关注当下的人更灵活，能很容易地克服工作压力，在混乱的情况下恢复正常，享受完成工作，做出更好的决定，拥有更好的人际关系，取得更多的成果。The article adds that people who can focus on their attention on the now are more flexible, can easily overcome workday stress and restore order after a chaotic situation, enjoy getting things done, make better decisions, have better relationships, and produce more.第二，脆弱。Number two, they are vulnerable. 你有没有注意到，向你展示脆弱的人会让你觉得自己和他们更亲近？ Have you noticed that feel more connected to people who show their vulnerability to you? 这是因为脆弱需要力量，这表明你能够认识到并接受真实的自己。这是一种有吸引力的品质。This is because being vulnerable takes strength, and it shows that you are able to recognize and accept yourself for who you truly are, which is an attractive quality to have. 牛津疗法认为，脆弱的其他好处是，它能帮你建立同理心。增强你处理情绪的能力，增强你的韧性，还能帮助你与他人建立更牢固的联系。Are the benefits of being vulnerable, according to aging therapy, is that it helps you build empathy, strengthens your ability to work through your emotions.Strengthens your resilience, and it helps cultivate stronger bonds with others. 第三，真诚可靠。 Number three, they are genuine and authentic. 你有没有想过为什么真诚的人有吸引力？ Have you ever wondered why people who are genuine and attractive? 在今日心理学的一篇文章中，持牌心理学博士盖伊温奇指出，真诚可靠的人比虚伪的人更有吸引力，有三个原因。 In an article of Psychology Today, licensed psychologist Guy Winch, PhD, states that there are three reasons why genuine and authentic people are more appealing than fake people. 第一，真诚和诚实。 The first one is truth and honest. 温奇表示，我们更有可能相信一个真诚的人，而不是一个虚伪的人，因为我们相信对自己真诚的人，也有可能对我们更真诚、更诚实。According to Winch, we are more likely to trust a genuine person than a fake one because we believe those who are truly to themselves are also likely to be truer and more honest with us. 第二，你会把真诚与坚强和情感弹性联系在一起。温奇表示这是正确的，因为对自己真实需要自信、坚韧，甚至勇敢。The second reason is that you associate being genuine with being strong in character and being emotionally resilient and correctly so. That says Winch. As being true to yourself takes confidence, tenacity, and often even bravery. 最后一个原因是人们通常被独特性和个性所吸引。温奇表示，真诚的人通常有大量优秀品质。The final reason is that people are normally attracted to uniqueness and individuality. Qualities genuine people usually have the space, says Winch. 第四，幽默。 Number four, they have a good sense of humor. 你能让别人开怀大笑吗？ Can you make others laugh a lot?虽然大笑可以让人们敞开自己，打开人际关系的大门，让他们放松，敞开心扉，但这也取决于幽默的类型。Why laughter can open the doors to people and relationships by putting them at ease to be more open, it can also depend on the type of humor.自我贬低、批评、评判和羞辱他人的幽默会让人离你而去，因为没有人喜欢感觉自己毫无价值。Humor that is self-depreciating, critical, judgmental, and mean to humiliate others can push people away, as no one likes to be made to feel worthless. 这就是为什么有魅力的人倾向于远离这种消极的幽默，而专注于让人自我感觉良好，让周围的人精神振奋的幽默。 This is why people with manic personalities tend to distance themselves from this type of negative humor and instead focus on humor that makes people feel good about themselves and which uplifts the people around them. 第五，富有创造力。 Number five, they are creative. 有没有想过为什么有创造力的人可以用他们做人艺术感动别人？ Even wonder why creative people can touch others with their art. 有创造力的人可以从不同角度看待事物，并与不同的人产生共鸣。 Creative people can see things from different perspectives and empathize with all parts of different people. 他们能理解让别人觉得自己备受关注的新想法和概念。 They understand the new ideas and concepts that make others feel seen.他们开放的思想也可以让他们不根据自己的信仰和感受来评判他人。 Their open-mindedness can also make it so that they don't judge others for their beliefs or feelings. 相反，他们会让你觉得在这个世界上并不孤单。 Instead, they can make you feel like you are not alone in the world.这种令人欣慰的非评判态度和认可创造了一个让人们感到安全和被关注的空间。 This comforting, no judgmental attitude and validation creates a place where people can feel safe and seen. 任何拥有这种品质的人都会自动被吸引，因为他们能给每个人带来彻底的接纳。Anyone with these qualities is automatically magnetic because of the radical acceptance they offer to everyone. 第六，天生好奇。Number six, they are naturally curious. 你对周围的世界和人好奇吗？ Are you curious about the world and the people around you?根据 Great Good 杂志上的一篇文章，好奇心可以帮助培养亲密感，并保护你免受负面社交体验的影响。According to an article in the Great Good magazine, curiosity can help foster closeness and protect you from negative social experiences.这篇文章指出，有好奇心的人能让别人感觉更平易近人，能更好地应对拒绝，不那么咄咄逼人，还能培养更多积极的社会体验。 The article states that people who are curious make other people feel closer to them, can cope better with rejection, are less aggressive andfoster more positive social experiences. 第七，健康的乐观主义。 Number seven, healthy optimism. 乐观通常吸引人，在某种意义上它给人希望。 Optimism usually attracts people because in a sense it gives hope. 心理学家伊丽莎白斯科特博士在一篇文章中表示，对于乐观主义者来说，消极的事情更有可能让他们振作起来，而积极的事情则会坚定他们的信念，让他们有能力让好事发生在现在和未来，让生活变得美好。 Psychologist Elizabeth Scott PhD says in an article that for people who areOptimists, negative events are more likely to roll up their back, while positive events affirm their belief in themselves, their ability to make good things happen now and in the future, and the goodness of life. 斯科特表示，在许多方面这种人生观对信徒有益。 This view of life according to Scott benefits the believer in various ways. 例如，研究表明乐观的人更健康，会取得更多的成就，不轻易放弃， 情绪更健康，更有可能积极的处理未来的挫折，活得更久，压力更小。 For example, studies have shown that optimistic people have better health, have more achievements, don't give up easily, have better emotional health, are more likely to positively handle future setbacks, live longer and have less stress. 第八，善于沟通。 Number eight, good communicators. 你善于沟通吗？ Are you good at communicating? 有魅力的人能够积极倾听和关注他人，他们说的话能让自己感到被倾听。 Magnetic people are able to actively listen and pay attention to others and what they have to say to make sure they feel heard. 有一种说法是，让别人感受到欢迎，展现出完成任务的能力，会吸引人。 The one thing states that making others feel welcomed and exuding the ability to get things done attracts people. 有魅力的人不仅知道如何用语言交流，还知道如何用肢体语言和个人能量交流。 Magnetic people to not only know how to communicate using words,but also with their body language and personality, personal energy. 他们也是很好的观察者，可以觉察到别人肢体语言和语调的变化。They are also good observers and can detect changes in other people's body language and tone of voice. 这使他们成为优秀的读者，能够按照他们的感知形式。This makes them good people readers who can act in accordance with what they perceive. 第九，精通专业和知识渊博。And number nine, well versed and knowledgeable. 因为他们的好奇心，有魅力的人会参与研究，了解大量的话题。Because of their curiosity, magnetic people attend to research and know about vast amounts of topics. 这有助于他们与各种各样的人互动和联系。This helps them interact and connect with a variety of different people. 拥有对每一科学科的大量知识也表明他们对周围的世界很精通，很感兴趣。 Having a vast amount of knowledge over a subject also signals how well versed and interested they are in the world around them. 这让他们更不容易相信谎言，更能跟上不同类型的对话。 It also makes them less prone to fall a lie and more able to keep up with varying types of conversation. 所以你的个性有魅力吗？ So do you have a magnetic personality? 这是第一篇文章哦。第二篇我们分享一下的名字叫每天十分钟冥想找回优雅的自己。哈佛大学的研究人员称，我们拥有 47% 的人 47% 的时间会迷失在思绪中。 Our minds are lost in thoughts 47% of the time according to researchers at the Harvard University.这些思绪通常源于两种情况，沉迷过去或担心未来。 These thoughts regularly stem from two cases. dwelling in the past or worrying about the future. 前者会引起悲伤和抑郁，后者会产生压抑和焦虑。The former can cause sadness and depression, and the latter can produce stress and anxiety. 我们经常因为琐碎的焦虑感而拖延。We often procrastinate over trivial feeling of anxiety. 拖延症之所以存在，仅仅是因为我们从未真正检查过焦虑是什么。And the procrastination takes hold simply because we never truly examine what the anxiety is. 冥想可以帮助你摆脱永无止境的如果一切可以重来和如果发生什么怎么办。Meditation can help pull you away from the never-ending what could have been and what ifs. 哥伦比亚大学医学中心的研究人员声称，冥想可以通过放松来改变大脑的结构和功能，这可以帮助你减少压力、焦虑和抑郁。Researchers at the Columbia University Medical Center claim Meditating can change the structure and function of the brain through relaxation, which can help you reduce stress, anxiety, and depression. 冥想不需要预留大量时间。Meditating doesn't require reserving a large chunk of your time. 事实证明，每天只需节省几分钟就可以减少分心并提高注意力。 Simple saving a few minutes per day has been proved to reduce distraction and increase focus. 作为一种治疗方法，冥想帮助我们注意到我们正在拖延意识的焦虑，命名焦虑，然后处理这种焦虑。As a cue, meditation helps us notice that we areprocrastinating because aware of the anxiety, name the anxiety, and then deal with that anxiety. 所以通常处理焦虑就像命名它并确定它不合法一样简单。 So often dealing with the anxiety is as simple as naming it and deciding it's not legitimate.比尔盖茨在他的博客中写道， Bill Gates wrote on his blog, 最近我对冥想有了更好的了解。 Lately, I've gained a much better understanding of meditation. 我现在每周冥想两到三次，每次大约十分钟。 I now meditate two or three times a week for about 10 minutes.Each time, 我现在看冥想只是对头脑的锻炼，类似于我们在运动时锻炼肌肉的方式。I now see that meditation is simply an exercise for the mind, similar to the way we exercise our muscles when we play sports. 如何通过两个简单的步骤进行冥想？ How to meditate in two easy steps?首先确定不会有外界的干扰，比如电话或可能打扰你的人。 Make sure first that there are no external distractions such as telephones or people who are likely to interrupt you. 然后请确保身体的放松，闭上眼睛。 Then make sure the body is relaxed. Close your eyes.深呼吸几次， take a few deep breaths. 这里有时候冥想师有一位名叫一行禅师和尚的和尚所写的。 Here's a meditation poem written by Buddhist monk named Thich Nhat Hanh. 它很短， it's very short. 吸气呼气， in, out, 深深的缓缓的 deep, slow, 平静放松 calm, ease, 微笑释放 smile, release。 你可以一边呼吸一边练习在脑海中朗诵这首诗。 You can practice reciting the poem in your mind while you breathe。 当你吸气时，你会专注于 in 这个词。 As you inhale, you focus on the word in. As you exhale, 专注 out. Inhale deep, 吸气深深的，呼气缓缓的。 Exhale slow. 如果任何时候当你感到因为焦虑或忧虑而分心，无法集中注意力时，可以先把注意力集中在你的呼吸上。If any time you are finding you feel distracted due to anxiety or worries and unable to concentrate, it is usually easier to focus on your breathing first. 有意识的呼吸会逐渐使你身心合一。 Conscious breathing will gradually put you in touch with the body.随着吸气的出入，关注你的呼吸。 Follow the breath with your attention as it moves in and out of your body. 感受呼吸时，感受你腹部轻微的扩张和收缩。 Breathe into the body and feel your abdomen expanding and contracting slightly with each inhalation and exhalation.这是第二篇，第三篇我们分享一下，题目的名称叫《磨难让我成为更好的自己》。加尔各答的特蕾莎修女有句经常被引用的话：“我知道上帝不会给我无法完成的事情，我只希望他不要那么信任我。” Mother Teresa of Calcutta was often quoted as saying, I know God will not give me anything I can't handle. I just wish he didn't trust me so much. 在过去的几十年中，我也有同样的感受。生活虽然蒙福，但却不易。Over the years, I have found myself often feeling the same way. I have had a blessed life.But it has never been an easy one. 在45年的岁月中，我经历了疾病、伤害、事故、痛苦。In my 45 years, I have had to deal with sickness, injuries, accidents, and pain. 除了年年的贫困和经济上的窘迫，我还要照顾智力有障碍的儿子，与爱所爱之人天人永隔，被迫分离。 I have had a deal with years of poverty and financial struggles. I have had to deal with my son's mental handicaps, the death of loved ones, and being separated from those I love. 还要面对悲愤、背叛、困惑、压抑，甚至还有时不时的绝望。I have had to deal with anger, betrayal, confusion, depression, and at times even despair. 像许多前人一样，我也不禁要问，为什么好人要遭受这么多的磨难？ Like so many before me, I have asked the question, why do bad things happen to good people?这个问题被追问已久，书上也没有答案。It is a question that has been asked throughout the ages. Books have even been written about it. 当我回忆起此生所经历的那些事情，我顿悟到原来上帝这么做是为了最终让我们成为更好的人。When I remember all that I have faced and gone through in this life, I realize that God has used all of it to eventually make me better.
痛苦带来同理之心，
悲哀带来求助之救助之心，挫折带来静候之心。With pain came empathy, with grief came hearing, with frustration came patience. 化悲愤为力量，苦尽甘来，因恨生爱，绝望中相信上帝的救赎。With struggles came strength, with sorrow came joy, with anger came love. 每一关，每一个挑战，每一个悲剧，在上帝的指引下，让我更仁慈、博爱，成为更好的人。And with despair came trust in God. Every test, challenge, and tragedy eventually led me to great goodness, great love, and great oneness with our Heavenly Father. 没有人喜欢负面经历，也没有人喜欢痛苦，更没有人喜欢经历历经悲伤。No one of us likes the negative experience in life. No one of us enjoys pain. No one of us wants to go through sorrow. 愿每天你都能成为更好的自己，更懂得爱。May each day here then help you to grow better and more loving.下面有一篇文章，我们 分享的是题目叫你的生活也可以满满全是爱。你可能正在寻找爱， Maybe you are looking for love， 可能你不确定是否能找到爱， Maybe you are unsure if you are ever find it， 可能你在谈恋爱，但还在想爱都去哪儿。 Maybe you are in a relationshipand wondering where all the love went. 无论你属于哪一种，在这里我想告诉你，缺乏爱不是你的错。 Regardless, I'm here to tell you that this lack of love is not your fault. 这意味着要从以下三个方面改变我们对爱的看法。 This means shifting our perspective on love.In three essential ways. 第一，不要寻找那种特殊的爱。与他人相处时，你要尽可能多地投入爱。Number one, instead of searching for that one special loving relationship, bring as much love as you can into all your relationships. 你可能一辈子会遇到很多灵魂伴侣，而那些恋情却没有坚持到最后。 You may have many soulmates in a lifetime, and those relationships may not last forever. 你的友谊可能比婚姻更持久。 Your friendships may last longer than your marriage. 这没什么问题，爱在你的生活中总会找到自己的位置。 And that is okay. Love expands to fill the spaceavailable. 关键是要你给爱留有一席之地。 The trick is making the space available. 世界上每一个，也包括你自己，都值得拥有爱。 Everyone on this planet, including yourself, is deserving of love. 每个人都值得被爱。 And everyone on this planet is deserving of your love.一旦我们不再执着于 某个人，我们就可以打开心扉，看见并爱每个人。Once we let go of this idea of the one, we open ourselves up to seeing and loving everyone. 第二，不要把爱看作是你无法控制的力量，要把它看作一种艺术和锻炼。Number two, instead of seeing love as a force that is out of your control, see it as an art and a practice. 我们都是爱的艺术家，但太多人拒绝拿起画笔，因为他们一直在等着要画的那幅对的画。We are all artists of love, but too many people refuse to pick up a paintbrush because they are waiting to find the right picture to paint. 只有我们真的采取点行动才会发现我们都拥有爱的潜力。We can only realize the tremendous potential we all have to love if we actually do something about it. 玛丽安娜·威廉姆森写道，我们体验到爱的有善良、给予、原谅、同情、平静、乐趣和接受。Marianne Williamson writes that we experience love as kindness, giving, forgiveness, compassion, peace, joy, and acceptance. 爱有一百万种不同的表现形式，这意味着我们每天有一百万种选择是否要把爱带进我们的生活。Love can show up in a million different ways, in a million different forms, which means we have a million choices every day to bring love into our lives or not. 我们的建议是选择去爱。My advice, choose love. 第三，不仅要爱人，也要爱上地方、事物和活动。Number three,Try falling in love not just with people, but also with places, scenes, and activities. 你可以爱上你装袋子的收银员， fall in love with the cashier bagging your groceries. 爱上把你安全带回家的司机， fall in love with the bus driver transporting you safely home. 爱上夜间给你的家带了安全的路灯，给你回家的。Fall in love with the street lamp that keeps your home secure at night. 早上，爱上早上阳光透过树叶洒下来的样子。Fall in love with the way the morning sunlight cascades through the trees.爱上你的热情， fall in love with your patience. 在生命的奇迹中，你的存在奇妙的令人难以置信。你真正最好的选择，那就是变成最慈悲、最有爱、最友善的人。Your existence is such an unbelievably fantastic event in this my miracle of life that the best and only really option is to.Become the most tender-hearted, loving, and kind individual you can possibly be. 下面一篇文章我们分享的题目是如何找到理想的工作 ,Tactics for job hunting success. 如果你觉得找工作是件棘手的事情，不妨扩展你找工作的计划。纳入以下策略。If you are finding it tough to land a job, try extending your job hunting plan to include the following tactics. 定下目标，尽管你应该永远给你的选择留有妥协余地，你也应确切地知道你到底想从某份工作中获取什么。Setting your target, why you should always keep your options open to compromise. You should also be sure to target exactly what you want in a job. 明确具体的寻找工作要比漫无目的的碰机会有效得多。A specific job hunting will be more efficient than aHaphazard one. 安排尽可能多的面谈 ,schedule ample interviews. 尽量利用一切办法去争取面试机会，回复招聘广告，求助搜寻公司，直接与公司联系，网上搜寻，利用各种关系网等等。Use every possible method to get interviews, answering ads, using search firms,contacting companies directly, surfing the web, surfing the web and networking. 即便某份工作对你不是最为理想的，但每次面谈都可以是一次有激励作用的经历。Even if a job is not perfect for you, even interview can be approached as a positive experience. 继续努力，即便人家没有雇佣你，给他们写张感谢卡，对给你安排了一次面试机会表示感谢。Following up, even if someone does not hire you, write them a thank you note for the interview. 数周之后，如果你申请的原职位或与你相关的其他职位尚无人选落实，你不妨再寄去一封简短的信，说明你还未找到理想的职位。如有机会再面试一次，将随叫随到。Then, some weeks later, send another brief letter to explain that you still have not found the perfect position and that you will be available to interview again if the original position you applied for or any other position for that matter.It's open. 你每次应聘、面试、求职都应该这样，没准儿你就会抓住一个机会。Do this with every position you interview for, and you may just catch a break. 将找工作视为全职工作，你偶然随便的找，不可能找到一份理想的工作，你必须去花时间找。Make it your full-time job. You can't find a job by looking sporadically. You have to make time for it. 如果你失业了，想再找份新工作，尽可能多地付出时间，就像你在全职工作一样。If you are unemployed and looking, devote as much time as you would to full-time job. 如果你有工作但还想找新的机会，制定一个有序的计划，尽可能多的安排出时间去搜寻。 If you have a job while you are looking, figure out an organized schedule to maximize your searching time. 纵向发展关系，在找工作的研究阶段，我找机会去和你渴望进入的行业中比你高一层的人次交谈，高一层次的人物交谈。Network vertically in the research phase of your job hunt. Talk to people who are on a level above you in your desired industry. 他们会有这层次人物所不具备的视野，会有能力雇佣你或将你推荐给其他雇主。There have some insights that people at your own level won't have and will be in a good position to hire you or recommend you to be hired. 心情愉快，充满希望。找工作是你必须做的最棘手的事情之一。Keep your spirits up. Looking for a job is one of the toughest things you will ever have to do. 保持信心，坚持不懈，态度乐观，最终你会找到适合你的工作。Maintain your confidence. Stay persistent and thinking positively.And eventually, you will get a job that suits you. 下面一篇文章我们分享的题目是生命中的五个球。生命中的五个球。Five balls of life。 几年前，在一所大学的开幕典礼中，可口可乐的首席执行官兰戴森讲到工作与其他义务的关系。 In a university commencement address several years ago, Brian Denson, CEO of Coca-Cola Enterprises, spoke of the relation of work to one's other commitments. 想象生命是一场不停丢正五个球于空中的游戏。Imagine life as a game in which you are juggling some five balls in the air. 这五个球分别为工作、家庭、健康、朋友和心灵，而且你很努力地挣着这五个球，不让他们落地。You name them work, family, healthy, friends, and spirit, and you are keeping all of these in the air. 很快你会了解，工作是一个橡皮球，如果你不幸失手落了它，它还是会弹回来的。You will soon understand that work is a rubber ball. If you drop it, it will bounce back. 但是家庭、健康、朋友和心灵这四个球是用玻璃做成的。But the other four balls, family, health, friends, and spirit are made of glass. 一旦你失手落下，他们可能会少了一角，留下无法挽回的记号、刻痕、损坏，甚至碎落一地。If you drop one of these, they will irrevocably scuffed, marked, nicked, damaged, or even shattered. 他们将永远不会跟以前一样。你必须了解这个道理，并且为平衡你的生命而努力。但要怎么才能做得到呢？ They are never be the same. You must understand that and strive for balance in your life. How? 别拿自己和他人比较，这只会降低了你原有的价值。Don't undermine your worth by comparing yourself with others. 因为我们都是独一无二的。因为我们每个人都很特别。 It is because we are different that each of us is special. 别人认为重要的事不一定是你的目标，只有你才知道什么是最适合你。 Don't set your goals by what other people deem important. Only you know what is best for you. 不要将贴近你心的人事物视为理所当然的存在。 Don't take for granted the things closest to your heart. 你必须将他们视为你生命的一般，好好的抓牢他们，没有他们生命将失去意义。 Cling to them as they would be your life, for without them life is meaningless.别让你的生命总在依恋过去种种，或寄望未来中失去。Don't let your life slip through your fingers by living in the past or for the future. 如果你活在每个当下，你就活出了生命中的每一天。By living your life one day at a time, you live all the days of your life. 当你还能给予的时候，别轻言放弃。Don't give up when you still have something to give. 只要你不放弃，你就有无限延伸的可能。Nothing is really over until the moment you stop trying. 别害怕承认你并非完美。Don't be afraid to admit that you are less than perfect. 正因如此，我们才能得以借由这脆弱的细丝紧紧地串绑在一起。It is aFragile thread that binds us to each together. 别害怕遇到危险，正因如此，我们才得以藉由这些机会学习勇敢。Don't be afraid to encounter risks. It is by taking chance that we learn how to be brave. 别以爱太难找借口，找到作为借口而紧闭你的心扉。Don't shut love out of your life by saying it's impossible to find. 最迅速的找到爱的方法就是给予你的爱。The quickest way to receive love is to give it. 最快速去爱的方法就是紧紧地守着你的爱不放。The fastest way to lose love is to hold it too tightly. Tightly. 维持爱的最好的方式就是给爱一双翅膀。And the best way to keep love is to give it wings. 莫要匆忙地度过你的一生，那匆忙让你忘了曾经到过哪里，也让你忘了你要去哪里。Don't run through life so fast that you forget not only where you've been, but also where you are going. 莫忘记人类情感上最大的需要是感恩。Don't forget a person's greatest emotion need is to feel appreciated. 莫害怕学习，知识没有重量，它是可以随时携带的珍宝。Don't be afraid to learn. Knowledge is witness, a treasure you can always carry easily. 莫漫不经心地蹉跎光阴或口无遮拦，时间与言辞两者都是一放便收不回来的。Don't use time or words carelessly, neither can be retrieved. 生命不是一场赛跑，而是一步一个脚印的旅程。Life is not a race, but a journey to be solved each step of the day. 过去已成历史，未来充满未知，今天是份礼物，那就是我们称之为现在的原因。Yesterday is history, tomorrow is a mystery, and today is a gift. That's why we call it the present. 最后一篇短文我们分享的是关于获得成功。关于获得成功 ,on achieving success, 我们不可能把每条路都走一遍，必须执着于一条道路才能获得成功。We cannot travel every path. Success must be one along one line. 我们必须有一个终身追求的目标，其他的只从属于这个目标。We must make our business the one life purpose to which every other must be subordinate. 我们痛恨做事半途而废。如果这件事是对的，就大胆勇敢地去做。如果这件事不对，就不要去做。I had a thing done by halves. If it be right, do it boldly. If it be wrong, leave it undoing. History 长河中的伟人，并不是靠终日展观镜中的自己来衡量自身的形象。The men of history were not.Perpetually looking into the mirror to make sure of their own size. 他们的形象来自对事业全身心的投入与追求。Absorbed in their work, they did it. 他们是如此的卓越超凡，于是芸芸众生觉得他们很伟大，并因此称他们为伟人。They did it so well that.The wandering world sees them to be great and labored them accordingly. 为崇高的理想而活着是一种成功的生活。To live with a higher idea is a successful life. 使人变强大，不是这个人做了什么，而是他努力尝试去做什么。It is not what one does, but what one tries to do.That makes a man strong. 有人说过，很久的警惕是自由的代价。Eternal vigilance, it has been said, is the price of liberty. 那同样也可以说， 不懈的努力是成功的代价 With equal truth is maybe said unseen effort is the price of success 倘若我们不尽全力工作别人会尽全力随后他们将在竞争中超越我们从我们手中夺得胜利的果实 If we do not work with our might others will and they will outstrip us in the race and pluck the prize from our grasp 成功越来越不依赖运气和巧合 Success grows less and less dependent on luck and chance 丧失自信是我们失败的主要原因Self-distrust is the cause of most of our failures. 性格是取得成功不可或缺的重要助力。The great and indispensable help to success is character. 性格是一种固化形成的习惯，是不断培养并坚信于此的结果。Character is a crystallized habit.The result of training and conviction. 每个人的性格都会受到遗传因素、环境和教育的影响。Every character is influenced by heredity, environment, and education. 除此以外，如果人在很大程度上不能成为自己性格的构筑者，那么他就会沦为宿命者，从而成为环境的失败造物。But this part, if every man were not to be great, extend the attractiveness of his own character, he would be a fatalist and irresponsible creature of circumstance. 与其说人是环境的造物，不如说是人是环境的建筑师更贴切一些。Instead of saying man is a creature of circumstance, it would be nearly the mark to say that man is an architect of circumstance. 同样的材料，有的人用其建造出宫殿，而有的人只能建成简陋的小屋。From the same materials, one man builds palace, other hovel. 在建筑师将其变成物之前，砖泥依然是砖泥。Bricks and mortar and are mortar and bricks until the architect can make them something else. 想到的多就永远不要奢望太多，想得到多就永远不要奢望太多。The true way to gain much is never to desire to gain too much. 智者不会在意他们得不到的东西。Wise men don't care for what they can't have. 好，今天的课就到这里哦。大家有没有需要分享的，或者需要咨询，或需要有什么建议的？可以举手我，或者我把大家解除静音啊。现在好了吧？我就是选择的文章都是实用性的，就是我看看大家有什么意见或建议，就是我根据大家的建议选择有针对性的文章或大家喜欢的文章， 在下次的分享当中跟大家分享。我觉得这些文章，我觉得对我们生活、工作、学习都有一点帮助吧，所以我选择这种类型的这种文章。大家有其他的好的建议，然后可以打在 chat 里面，或者说说一下，我下次就选择根据大家这个要求选择类似的文章跟大家分享。
谢谢平老师。
啊，不谢不谢。